So let's step back a moment and look at these results for these two extremes. So we had this one extreme where we bet all 1,000 chips on a single coin flip, and another where we bet one chip on each of 1,000 coin flips. Now the risk-adjusted reward, or the Sharpe ratio, for the single bet was 0.63. In other words, if we bet all 1,000 chips on a single flip of the coin, our Sharpe ratio is 0.63. So let's call this SR single. Now the Sharpe ratio, if we bet 1,000 times, in other words, one chip on each of 1,000 tables, turns out to be 20. So what's the relationship between these two? Of course, 20 is about 40 times bigger than 0.63, but there's something more interesting there. And it turns out that it's this. So if we take the single bet case and multiply it by the square root of 1,000, we get the Sharpe ratio of our multi-bet scenario where we bet 1,000 at once. So isn't that curious? So it turns out that in general, if you carry this scenario out to more examples, that if you split your bets evenly across multiple tables, this relationship will hold. In other words, the Sharpe ratio for the single bet, 1,000 chips on one table, is sort of our base case, and as we spread it out over more and more tables, the Sharpe ratio improves by the square root of that number of bets. And this relation is exactly like the fundamental law of active portfolio management, namely, our overall performance is related to the skill in the case of making a single pick times the square root of the number of picks that we're able to make. So our coin flip casino has helped to show us how we can derive an equation like this for betting, which is what buying stocks really is, and to show that you can improve things either by having more skill. In the case of coin flips, skill is how biased is the coin. In the case of investing, it's how good are you at predicting the future return of a stock. Or you can improve your performance by increasing your breadth, but you only get to improve it by the square root of your breadth.